What's up, guys? It's that time guy again here, bringing you back episode 15 of our Let's Play Skyrim Special Edition. And I'm sorry if every intro seems different, I kind of forget what I'm supposed to say. But anyway, in the last episode, we went through Blackreach, surprisingly easy. Again, I'm still over... I'm sorry, she had to interrupt my intro. So, we went through Blackreach pretty easily, actually. I'm still surprised about that. We took on our fifth dragon? I don't know, I've lost count. And, we were granted permission to buy property in Fogwreath. So, in today's episode, we are going to continue with the storyline, but first, I don't know how this happened, but... We never retrieved our equipment from Delphine's hideout, so we're gonna do that first, real quick, like, real quick.
Welcome. Let me know if you want anything. I think I got a clean mug around here somewhere.
Oh, thanks, dude. I'm just gonna take your cheese. Cause one of my subscribers knows I love cheese. So, I don't even remember what equipment we have or had. See, the trunk was empty. That was a big old waste of time. Okay, Lydia, come on down. Come. She doesn't really have any potions that I want. I'll take those arrows, though. Those would be nice. Nothing there. Okay, so, anyway, let's mush on. And we need to go to the Throat of the World because Parthenax is waiting for us to read the Elder Scroll. Oh, and before I start recording, a thief tried to steal something and he got shot in the face. So we're just gonna put him right there in the shade. He's sleeping. We don't want to wake him. Alright, so let us make our way to the Throat of the World. So how's it going, guys? Today is Wednesday when this video will be going up. It's hump day again, or it's Wednesday, my dudes. I don't know which meme you prefer more. So we are here, and just so we're kind of clear on what we have to do, we're going to turn on that
you
marker.
The Kel, the Elder Scroll.
Whoa, Parthenax, do not scare me like that. You need to not scare me like that, man. Yes, I've got the Elder Scroll, bro. I like how there's just like this weird vortex right here that kind of makes it obvious that you have to read the Elder Scroll right here. So let's do that. I hate how the Elder Scroll weighs 20 whatever. Because that's freaking heavy. So we gotta read it. And we're gonna be sucked through time and space. And for right now, I'm gonna shut up just so you guys can hear the dialogue from this.
Today, Alduin's lordship will be restored. But I honor your courage, Kreefwolf Akrin. Die now in vain.
Battle below goes ill. Falduin does not rise to our challenge. I fear all may be lost.
You worry too much, brother. Victory will be ours.
Why does Alduin hang back? We've staked everything on this plan of yours, old man.
He will come. He cannot ignore our defiance. And why should he fear us, even now?
We blooded him well. Four of his kin have fallen to my blade alone this day.
None have yet stood against Alduin himself. Galdor, Sori, Birkar.
They did not have Dragonrend. Once we bring him down, I promise, I will have his head.
You do not understand. Alduin cannot be slain like a lesser dragon. He is beyond our strength. Which is why I brought the Elder Scroll.
Feldir, we agreed not to use it.
I never agreed. And if you are right, I will not need it.
We will deal with Alduin ourselves. Hear it now.
We shall see soon enough. Alduin approaches.
So be it.
Mele, Tarodis, Ani, Himhint Paliv, Fuhidan.
Let those that watch from Sovngarde envy us this day.
Okay, I'm sorry, I have to interrupt, but I like how the fighting is so uneventful. Well,
worked. Did it.
Yes, the World Eater is gone. May the spirits have mercy on our souls.
And that's a guess. That's our little flashback there. So now we know Dragonrend. Shocker that had come from the Elder Scroll. So, we are going to equip that, and we're also going to equip the dragon bait, yeah. Just one second, okay. Because, surprise, surprise, we get to fight Alduin for the first time from... pretty much him saving us, we have to kill him. It's kind of sad that we have to kill him. I mean, not in the sense that he's bringing dragons back and that he wants to destroy everything in mankind, but just the fact that he saved us, dogs. You know, he saved us, you know. Why do we have to kill somebody who saved us, you know? I mean, obviously he's evil, so I mean, that kind of makes sense, but... still, the dude saved us. I don't know why the game doesn't give us the option to, join Alduin. Come on. You're supposed to land. No, I don't think so, buddy. I don't think so. That's bullcrap. Bullcrap. No, none of that. None of that. Bad dragon. Bad Alduin. Bad. Nope, get back here, Buster. Toasty. Toasty, toasty. Yeah, we got Parthenax, we've got Lydia. We are all right. We are all right. And we are not all right because we need to use a potion. Or two. Or three. Oh, Lydia, are you okay, Lydia? I don't see you. I don't see you. I hope she's okay. Oh, goodness gracious. Oh, thank you, God, I have some of these. I need one more. Buddy. Oh, come on. You know, this is one thing I don't like about Alduin's fight, is he summons all these freaking meteors or asteroids or whatever to come and rain upon a fiery hell upon us. I'm sorry, I just totally butchered that, but yeah, it's just like, I don't understand that. Like, why? Stop that. Bad dragon. Bad Alduin. And you are getting Dragon Ram again. Oh, hot diggy dog. Do we have food? Oh yeah, we got that cheese I got. Yeah, that cheese. That cheese, man. Weapon recharge, yeah, we already know that. This is what kind of sucks about, oh, wait, no. Oh, crapola. We have... Wait, the way you recharge your weapons, for those who don't know, and I pretty much know a lot of people know by now, you go to the weapon, you press whatever button it is, mine is RB, and then you choose from the soul gems you have. So I'm just going to recharge it a little bit because we're almost done here. See, we defeated Alduin! Yay! The world's not going to end anymore! Yay! Hooray! Yeah, just kidding, guys. This is not the end. Lydia, calm. Look at her go! She's just like, I ain't done until he's done. Oh, okay, now she stopped. Oh, not funny anymore. Okay, yeah, so, this is not where we... unfortunately, this isn't where we defeat Alduin. So, we have to talk to Esbern or, that dude with the gray beard, or Parthenax. And since Parthenax is basically right here, well, I don't know why they give us the option to talk to any of them when we could just walk right over here and talk to Parthenax. It's like, my dude, really? Yeah, okay, so...
You truly have the voice.
I'm sorry, guys, I gotta drink some water.
Alduin's allies will
die of thirst
twice after this victory.
Yeah, it wasn't really a victory.
Nilivrach in Moro. True, this is not the final Krongrah victory. But not even the heroes of old were able to defeat Alduin in open battle.
This is true.
Alduin always was Pahlok, arrogant in his power. Uznagar Par. He took domination as his birthright.
Oh, and you guys are gonna have fun when we have to deal with some Civil War stuff when it comes to trying to get to Alduin. I need to find out where Alduin is in.
One of his allies could tell us. Matmahus, but it will not be so easy to convince one of them to betray him.
Okay.
Perhaps the Hafkasayun.
I'm guessing dragons ain't loyal.
In Whiterun, Dragon's Reach. It was originally built to house a captive Dova. A fine place to trap one of Alduin's allies, hmm?
Yeah. The Jarl White One might not think so, though.
Yes, but your Soom is strong. I do not doubt that you can convince him of the need.
Dragon Disease was really built to hold a dragon?
This was ages ago, you understand. There were more of us then. Before the Bruniki, the Akaviri came and killed all my Zema. I used to visit him from time to time, nearly crazed by loneliness and captivity. Tiraz Sivaz. He did not even remember his own name. I do not.
Okay, so he's just going to ramble on a little bit, so let's stop talking to him. Okay, so we have to go talk to the Jarl of Whiterun. Okay, so we're here. And let's put our weapons away, because we're not trying to spook the Jarl. Oh, wait, let's level up first, guys. Let's level up. Put in the stamina. And where are we going to put our perk? Still can't do it there. Can we do it here? Nope. I don't know, guys. Where should I put this perk? Lockpicking? Nope, can't put anything there yet. Speech? Yeah, let's do speech. Because prices will be 10% better, so let's do that. We're gonna put some perks into speech, because the prices are too damn high that when I try to buy stuff, and the prices are too damn low when I try to sell stuff. So we're gonna invest some perks into that. Alright, y'all. Where are you? Oh. Okay. Guess we're gonna have to just wait a little bit. So let's wait about, 10 hours? Yeah, that seems like a good amount of time to wait, you know? Just so it's morning. Alright, Jarl, where are you? It's morning. Okay, come on. What's up? Alright, Jarl. What's up? I need your help. I need to trap a dragon in your palace.
I must have misheard you. I thought you asked me to help you trap a dragon in my palace.
You heard right. The only way to stop the dragons.
What you're asking for is insane. Impossible. You want me to let the dragon into the heart of my city? With the threat of war on my doorstep?
The threat is worse than we know. Alduin has returned.
Alduin? The world eater himself? But how can we fight him? Doesn't his return mean it's the end times?
It's only hopeless if we give up, man.
I didn't say anything about giving up. Now what's this nonsense about trapping a dragon in my palace?
It's the only way to find Alduin before it's too late.
I want to help you, Dragonborn. And I will. But I need your help first.
Oh my god.
Ulfric and General Tullius are both just waiting for me to make a wrong move. Do you think they will sit idle while the dragon is slaughtering my men and burning my city? No. I can't risk weakening the city while we are under the threat of enemy attack. Sorry.
What if I do have... Wait, excuse me, sorry. What if you didn't have to worry about any enemy attacking?
Then I would be glad to help you with your mad dragon-trapping scheme. But getting both sides to agree to a truce will be difficult at this point. The bitterness has gone too deep. Maybe. What of the Greybeards? They are respected by all Nords. High Hrothgar is neutral territory. If the Greybeards were willing to host a peace council...
Yeah, so this is what I meant by the Civil War stuff, guys, because...
have to listen.
As you know, General Tullius and Ulfric do not like each other. So, we gotta talk to them. But first, we need to go talk to the Greybeards. So, just because like he said, I'm gonna what am I thinking of? I'm gonna rehash it. I'm gonna say, the Greybeards are respected by pretty much everybody in Skyrim, and High Hrothgar is neutral territory, so there won't be any fighting. It's just gonna be strictly man talk. It's gonna be, you have what I want, and you have what I want, and I have what you need. So let's trade. So we're just gonna talk to the Greybeards real quick, see, we're gonna get their approval, quote unquote. Okay, what's up?
Alduin? We heard the Dragonwren shout from here. You defeated him?
Yes, but he escaped after a portal to Sovngarde.
I feared as much. I thought it was him we saw flying east after your battle.
I need your help. I need to capture a dragon.
We are not warriors. What is overlooked in
you guys aren't warriors.
Is not permitted to any other followers of the way of the voice.
I need your help
you
to stop the war.
Understand our authority. The Greybeards have never involved themselves in political affairs.
Well, what do you guys do then?
I see. The dragon will lead you to Alduin, but without the Jarl's help.
Both sides respect the Greybeards. They will listen.
Artanax has made the decision to help you. This is the road we have to walk. Even the Greybeards must bend to the winds of change, it seems.
Bruh, just help me out.
Tell Ulfric and General Tullius that the Greybeards wish to speak to them. We will see if they still remember us.
Okay, so now we have to go talk to General Tullius and Ulfric Stormcrow. So, I'm just gonna go fast travel to those places. So, I will meet you when I get to, Solitude and Winterhold. Or, Winterhold. Windhelm. Sorry. Be right back. Alright, guys, we're here in the palace in, Solitude. So, General Tullius, my boy.
Are my men now giving free rein to anyone who wanders into the castle?
Bruh.
Do you have some reason to be here, citizen?
I do. I believe we already met, though.
Have we? Oh, of course. You were at Helgen.
Yep.
One of the prisoners, if I recall correctly.
yeah, about that, I helped Hagvar escape, and he said he'd vouch for me.
Hagvar's alive. I hope that's true. He's a damn good soldier. But he hasn't reported in yet, so he can't exactly confirm your story.
Alrighty then.
You have a chat with Legate Ricca. I suspect we might.
No! I don't want to talk to. What's his face? I don't want to join you guys. I have a message from the Greybeards, actually.
What do those old hermits want with me?
They're. Kind of peace council, Hrothgar, you know.
There's nothing to
you
discuss
know
as long as that traitor Ulfric is in arms against his rightful emperor.
We need a truce until the dragon menace is dealt with.
They are getting to be a problem, but I wasn't sent to Skyrim to fight dragons. My job is to quell this rebellion, and I intend to do just that, dragons or no dragons.
Okay, this is a perfect time to say this. Boy! Okay, got that out of the way. Dragons are a bigger problem with Stormcloak right now. I'm sorry, I totally read that wrong. The dragons are a bigger problem than the Stormcloaks right now.
I'll be the judge of that. Besides, by all reports, the Stormcloaks are suffering just as much as we are from these dragon attacks.
Boy, you better listen. Okay, It's time to negotiate for a strong position. Yeah.
Fair enough. We're driving the Stormcloaks back well enough.
Okay, so he agreed. Let's go to wait, hold on. Let me wait for that number.
Every day, more enforcements I've requested.
Is it as you
were. It's not a cause. It's a rebellion.
Call it whatever. Okay, are you gonna go or not? The man's going to take White Run.
Jarl Baldruf.
Baldruf refuses the Legion's right to garrison troops in his city.
Right. On the other hand, he
refuses to acknowledge Ulfric's claim.
Bro, did you like seriously not listen to me?
What do the? Why? There's nothing to do.
They okay, so
my job is to quell this rebellion, and I intend to do just that. You may have a point. Yes. Yep.
Okay, there we go. Okay, so I'll meet you guys in Windhelm. All right, guys, we are amidst the palace of the True High King of Skyrim. I mean, Ulfric Stormcloak. So we're gonna head inside, and my phone will go off, and then we'll talk to Ulfric.
He's a true Nord. He'll come around.
My boy, my king. I mean, Ulfric. Hello.
You were at Helgen with us. Come to join the.
Yeah, he remembers me, guys. He remembers me. Yes, sir. Okay, well, that's not the real reason I'm here. I have a message from the Greybeards.
They turned their gaze from the heavens back to our bleeding homeland. What do they want?
They have a negotiation of a truce, my lord.
I have the greatest respect for the Greybeards, of course. And the dragon attacks are a growing plague. But
I agree.
The political situation is still delicate. Not all the Jarls are fully committed to supporting me as High King. I can't afford to appear weak. I can't agree to this unless Tullius himself will be there.
General Tullius has already agreed to attend.
Good. We still hold half of Skyrim despite everything the Empire could throw at us. I doubt the Empire has the stomach for much more bloodletting.
So you'll come to the Peace Council?
I'll give Tullius one more chance.
Oh, thank you. Thank you, True High King. I mean, Ulfric. Mr. Stormcloak, it's been an honor. Okay, guys, so now we gotta go back to High Rothgar. Alright, guys, so we're back at High Rothgar. And we are going to go inside in the next episode. So we actually did a lot today, so we'll save the Peace Council for next episode, guys. So, We did a lot. We took on Alduin. We talked to Ulfric, the Jarl of what's that place called? Oh, Whiterun. And we talked to General Tullius. So I think this is probably the most appropriate spot to end today's video. So if you like today's video, so please go ahead and hit that like button. Comment down below. And hit that subscribe button as well. And I will see you in the next video. Peace.